Atkins the winner, he qualifies. Nylander in second place, Morey third, Araujo in fourth place, and just look at the times, six of them inside 49 seconds. Jon Ridgeon in seventh place, 49.43, just outside his best time this season. And he's here now with Brendan Foster.
John, on the one hand, you may be a little disappointed with that run, but you've actually achieved your Olympic ambition 8 years later.
Yeah, it's wonderful to be here. To make the semi-final was great. I always dreamed of making the final, and I knew it was going to be really tough, and it was, you know. I came, what, sixth or seventh out there in the semi. But, yeah, a year ago, I couldn't even run. You know, here I am, 8 years after my first Olympics, running again. It's fabulous.
What's the message out there for athletes who find themselves in difficulty like yourself?
Well, I mean, I don't know, I retired and accepted it was all over, but I guess, you know, if you have a lot of unlucky years, you're going to have one or two lucky years. And this is a great first year for me, and I just want to build on it now, and I've trained only 6 months in 3 years, and hopefully another good winter, and I'll be really dangerous next year.
Have you enjoyed it?
Ah, it's been fabulous. The Olympics is just the ultimate. It doesn't get any better than this.
What about your roommate, Roger Black, ran a great race yesterday?
Yeah, I mean, that's inspiration. He's had such a good year, and it's great, been great for me to spend the year with him and help him, and there's still the relay to come, and those guys could do something really special.
Well, John, I'll tell you, I thought you were in this side of the track if we'd talked about it a year ago, but well done getting here and well run.
Thanks very much, it's been fun.